Hi, today I will introduce you to a topic you may not be very familiar with, that robots may become a huge part of our world and that we may have to work harder, learn more, and prove that we are better. While robots may be very good in doing repetitive jobs, like producing toilet paper, we will always have to be the ones coming up with the ideas, like in TED. Let's play a game before we start, though. Clap once if you haven't heard that your dear McDonald's is now using a robot as a waiter. You have a lot to learn. First, we need to understand that we can't just think, oh, we have a few more years to understand or stop this. We can. First of all, we can't stop this. It's part of our evolution as humankind. We should not be doing all these jobs that take no imagination. We should be doing something better that helps us. These jobs of producing toilet paper don't actually help us, and they don't require imagination, but they tire your body even though you're not using your brain for them. Robots are good at such jobs. What I'm saying is that it's not necessarily a bad thing that robots may be doing some of our jobs, unless we don't know it and we don't prepare ourselves for it. Second of all, we don't have a few years. It's happening now, like the McDonald's, I said. When I say a robot, you probably think of something that rolls around on wheels and talks. Well, there are two types of robots. Like the one McDonald's is using, looks a lot more like this, a desktop. It's actually just software, an app. People just click what they want to eat, and that's it. Well, I guess that kind of helps, since those people that were gonna work for McDonald's don't actually live a very good life, and their job doesn't actually really help them. Another example is Pepper, a robot that rolls around phone stores and helps people pick their mobile phones. Now, this is what you imagine a robot to be, probably, right?
Yeah.
So, a study conducted by the International Labor Organization states that as many as 137 million workers across five countries in Asia, approximately 56% of the total workforce of those countries, at risk of displacement by robots. Now, I am saying this so that you are aware, and that when you're grown up, you'll actually know that you learned when you were a kid, and that when you're a kid, you actually know that you can't get off with an easy job at McDonald's, and you actually learn to do a job that helps you and improves you. My mom, who works at Coca-Cola, and you heard from Mr. Rivera, her work uses robots. Well, those people who have the jobs that the robots are doing, they are actually now having a new job to come up with new ideas for new robots. And my mom asked them how it feels to do that, and they said they were very happy to be doing a job that actually helps them, and that they have more fun doing it. So most of the time, in most cases, those robots are not only for the company's sake and economy, it's also to make the people happier. And those people may actually end up having a better life after the robots took their jobs. And after all, maybe robots may even help us to have better jobs by eliminating the chance of us having a boring job, if believe it or not. So in conclusion, I think all we have to do to be happy is to know that this is happening, and then we will just grow up and have a good job. Thank you.